Hey y'all, thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to check out another one of my videos. And if you're new around here, hello and welcome. My name is Katie Marie and I am a lover of eyeshadow palettes, and today is one of my favorite videos to do, and it is when I get to sit down and play with a new palette. And today's palette is going to be the Nomad Cosmetics Cartagena Magica palette. I hope I said that right. I'm not gonna tell you guys how I pronounced it the first time I saw Nomad, like share the name. But we're gonna go with my attempt of it. But this is the palette we're gonna be getting into. I'm gonna do swatches, I'm gonna show you guys an eye look and give you guys my first impressions. So if that sounds interesting to you, you can just keep on watching. But before we dive into it, I do wanna do my Instagram shout out for today. And today's Instagram shout out goes to Dahlia_red_. She commented on my most recent post. So thank you so much, Claudia, for interacting with my latest post and leaving me so much love on it. I really do appreciate it. And you are my Instagram shout out for today. And per usual, if you want a chance to be featured as my Instagram shout out, all you have to do is be following me on Instagram. I'm LadyKatie92. Interact with my content as it goes up, and I randomly select someone when I sit down to film. Yes, I stumbled over my words there. Anyway, moving on. But anyway, now at this point, we can just go ahead and dive right into it. I know I am probably the last one to be getting my first impressions on this palette out because it is Tuesday now. I just got this palette yesterday. It was supposed to come in, I think, Thursday, and then it got pushed to Friday, and then it just didn't come in until Monday because, if you don't know, Hurricane Sally came through and hit Florida, hit Pensacola. I live in Pensacola, so mail was delayed. But anyway, I'm really excited, and even though, like I said, I'm probably the last person to be sharing my first impressions, I still wanted to do first impressions on it because I was so very excited to get this palette. So let's jump right into swatching it first, and then I'll get into my tutorial for it, and then give you guys kind of my overall first impressions. Okay, so here is what the palette looks like inside, and I'm so excited to swatch it. I've already done eye look, obviously, but I have actually not swatched them all out on my arm, so I'm excited to see what they look like on my arm. Let me scoot over a little bit, and then we can get started, and I'm just going to go from the top over. All right, so I'm just going to start at the top here. Here's this first one. This first one I thought was a matte, but it's actually a shimmer. And I think that's something I definitely noticed in general when it comes to Nomad Cosmetics. They do like their, not shimmers, they're satin. This is a satin, this is more of a shimmer. But this is very much a satiny color. And that's something I found. I've only used one other palette from them, the Lake Como palette. And I definitely did notice that they like their shimmers more than like intensely foiled or intensely anything. They just like very soft formulas. But here's what they look like. I'm gonna go over one more time because I feel like I didn't do this shade justice. This shade I used in my inner corner today, it's really, really pretty. The yellow is really nice, and then this shade here I didn't use today, but there it is. I love the designs they've etched in here. It's so very pretty. I didn't get pictures, which I'm kind of kicking myself for, but again, I'm like the last person to share my video here, so I was like, ah, I'll just use it today. And I think it's going to be like rainy and cloudy for the next couple days, so I didn't want to wait. But let's go ahead and do the next four, I should say. The formula is so very beautiful. Like, to touch and feel, it's just lovely. I absolutely love touching it. It's so smooth, so finely milled, even like the shimmers and the mattes. They are really nice. That might be a downside depending on like what you like in an eyeshadow, because they are so finely milled that, you know, they're very pigmented, but they're also very soft. Like, I feel like you only get so much intensity when it comes to their shadows, especially this palette, because it's so kind of monochromatic mid-tone. But there are the next four. Really pretty. I really enjoy a summery palette, and I feel like this one just screams summer. It has that little pop of purple in it to make it interesting. It totally goes with the color story, so I was excited. Okay, if this one looks a little shimmery, I just swatched it out of order. Let's get back to it. This orange I also used today. I really like that orange. Again, kind of reiterating, I wouldn't like turn to this palette if you're wanting like very intensely foiled or metallic, but if you like soft shimmers, if you like satiny colors, I think you will like this formula. It's definitely, I wouldn't say my ideal when it comes to my type of shimmers, just because, like I said, it's so soft, but I still really enjoy it. I think you just have to go in not expecting anything super metallic, and then you'll, you know, you won't be surprised. And I feel like the look that I got just working with this, I was kind of expecting it, having already used Lake Como. But anyway, getting a little distracted, let's finish up with these three more. I think just swatching these out now, I think that first shade is only like true satin formula. Everything else is either matte or like a soft shimmer. Some of them are more of like topper, like iridescent type of shades. Like, I would say, let me make sure I'm in frame. This shade is definitely a topper, at least for me personally. And even this shade here, and maybe this shade, these have more pigments to them, so they kind of stand on their own two feet. But there is a look at this palette, just all swatched out on my arm. Per usual, I always stick up close-ups. But yeah, just touching it now, as I was, you know, kind of sharing with you guys, the mattes are so smooth, so like like they just feel pillow soft. I can't describe it. I was trying to think, you know, if you ever like touch into powdered sugar, how light and airy that is. That's kind of what this reminds me of whenever I tap into this palette. And same with the Lake Como. So like Nomad in general, their matte formula is just so very soft, so buttery smooth, and so very pigmented. And then the shimmers, like I said, I would definitely describe them more as a soft shimmer. And then some of them have color to them and are a soft shimmer. And other ones are just more of like that soft topper shade. But with saying that, every one of these shimmers, while they may not pack a punch in the metallic side of things, they definitely pack a lot when it comes to like the sparkle and the reflect, because just opening this palette, each one of them just has all this sparkly shimmer that shines back on me, and it's absolutely beautiful. And for me, if I'm gonna go with a soft shimmer, I at least like to see something sparkling back at me, so I was happy to see that. Anyway, those are the swatches. I'll stop yammering on. Let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial, and then I'll sum up more of my thoughts at the end. Okay, so I'm not going to be saying any names here. I'll just be putting them up on the screen. But I took that first yellow shade and I put that into my crease. As I've already said, the mattes in here are just so very buttery smooth, so beautiful. Something I noticed throughout this whole look is that it doesn't take a lot of work. If you're someone who likes a one and done, very quick and easy, I feel like Nomad's formula in general will be right up your alley, because it just... I don't know, I feel like I'm going around circles, but it doesn't take a lot of work. You put it on, you make sure it's kind of all over where you want it, and you're done. It doesn't really build up on itself that much, but it doesn't really need to build up on itself, because the color you put down is the color you see in the pan, and that's the color you get, I guess is what I'm saying. But anyway, that went on very smoothly. Very happy with that. I decided to go into that shade all the way on the end that, like I said, I'm not going to be pronouncing it. But I took that shade right into the crease to deepen it up and just to add some depth. And as you see, I thought this blended and built on top of itself very nicely. But once again, the color you put on initially, like it's almost there instantaneously. Like it's very easy to put it on. You kind of blend around the edges and then boom, it's done. It didn't take me a lot of work at all to get this look and, you know, finish out that crease. I thought it layered on top of the yellow very nicely, blended and meshed into the yellow very nicely, and it was very quick and easy to do. For the outer corner, I decided to take the shade on the second row all the way on the right, and I packed that right onto my crease. And as you can see, I once again, very, very pigmented, very easy to build on, took no work. I felt like I was just kind of dabbing and swiping around the edges, and before I knew it, it was like, oh wait, it's already blended out. Like, I don't need to work this hard. And I feel like that's something I kept having to remind myself, because I would go to work on it and apply it, and I would be blending, and I'd be like, wait, why am I blending so much? Like, I don't need to. And that's just something I was very impressed about, just the ease and the quickness that I could get a look. And I was surprised how often I had to remind myself to stop working so hard, because it wasn't needed. From there, I decided to take that orange shimmer shade on the middle row and I packed that on my center lid. This shade is definitely, like I said, all of them are in general, I would describe them as more of a soft shimmer, but it was nicely pigmented. I feel like though, just to kind of cut corners and make it easier and quicker, my finger was definitely the way to go, or some type of very flat brush to really pack it on, because that just made it quick and easy. I was doing it with a brush, and I even wet the brush, and I definitely got it there, but I could have taken my finger, dabbed it in, and rubbed it on, and had it in 2 seconds. So definitely, if you want the maximum payoff, the quickest finger is the way to go, or some type of a sponge applicator that gives you that look. That would be my recommendation, and in future, I plan to just use a sponge tip applicator. And then for the rest of my lid, I took that gold shade on the top row, and I just applied it with a brush. I did go ahead and put some glitter glue underneath this just to help with the stickiness, because this did look and appear, when I kind of swatched on my finger, looked more like a topper shade, and I definitely feel like that glitter glue helped a whole lot to help it adhere. But as you can see, it's very beautiful. It went on nice and pigmented. It took a little bit of work to build up, because like I suspected, it is more of a topper shade to give you that just intense sparkle, not so much color. But I was wanting color in this look, so that's why I went on and packed it on there, and I was really happy with the look that I got. Took me a little bit of extra work to pack it on there and get it to that intensity, but I have the color I want, and the amount of sparkle, the amount of glitter reflect that I see now that it's on there is intense. I was so impressed. I think it's very beautiful, and it definitely has a lot more sparkle and intensity than the orange does. So something to note. At this point, I stopped and finished my makeup, and then I came back to my lower lash line, which I took that dark orange, or brownish orange, I guess you could say, and put it right against my lower lash line. Again, took no work to do. And then just to do a pop of something different, I took that purple shade, the purple shimmer, all the way on the bottom right of the pan, and I just kind of packed that on right underneath on my inner half of my lower lash line, and it popped right away. It's very, very purple, and even, you know, a couple hours later, I've been wearing this and I just see the purple shining from this look, and I feel like it gives a really pretty look and effect effect to this look, and I really like it. And then for my inner corner, I took that yellow all the way on the left side, that shimmer. It's the second shade in the palette, but I packed that on my inner corner, and that almost has a touch of like duochrome-ness to it. It's very pretty. It reminds me of like Terra Moon's Iridescent Chameleons. Not as intense, so don't get me wrong, but it definitely just has that kind of like a softer sister, little sister to that Iridescent Chameleon. It definitely gave me those vibes, I'll say that, but I was very happy with how intense that looks on the inner corner. And then as a very final step, I went ahead and took that very first shade. I think it's called Alpha. Maybe I can pronounce that one, but I took that and just dabbed it on the very top of my brow bone. This isn't a matte. This is actually a satin finish, so it looked very pretty on my brow bone because it wasn't super shimmery, but it wasn't very dull and matte, so it gave me just a little bit of reflect on my brow bone, and it kind of was just that final step to help blend everything in my crease, and I liked how it looked. But yeah, that is going to do it for this look. Here's the completed look, and per usual, I like to stick up a couple close-ups so you guys can see. I feel like it was very easy and effortless to get this look. The look is still really pretty, and while there isn't a whole lot of dimension and depth you could get in this palette, I still feel like I got a very pretty amount of depth and a decent amount of depth. I would say this like is mid-tone for me and my preferences when it comes to what I like on my outer corner. It's kind of mid-tone. It's not too light, which I don't like when it's super light on my outer corner, so I was very happy to see I could get some depth, but it's definitely not as dark as I tend to like to go. But overall, I was very happy with how this look turned out, very pleased with my first look, and I cannot wait to do more looks with it. At this point, I just want to give a couple first impressions. Again, keep in mind this is a very first impression. I've only done one look, the look you see today, with this palette, so I definitely want to continue playing with it to get more of my thoughts on it, but I have done two other looks with a previous palette, the Lake Como palette from Nomad, so I have a little bit of a feel for their formula, and I definitely like their formula. I can't say it's my absolute favorite because I'm such a lover of just smoking out and getting so much depth in my outer corner that I do miss it when it comes to their formula because I feel like it's just very gentle, or I shouldn't say formula, because there is deep colors in the Lake Como, but this palette, it's just such a soft formula, and then the colors aren't that intense that the whole look, I feel like, has a soft look to it. But I don't want to harp on too long about that because, like I said, what you see is what you get, so I was expecting that. But just talking about the formula, the mattes blow me away. Like I was saying in the tutorial, I could not believe how quick and easy it is to work with these shades. It's one and done, and like you saw, I used the three shades, you know, two in my crease, one in the outer corner. They blend into each other like a dream. Now, granted, all of these colors kind of go together, so I shouldn't be too surprised, but blending them together was so easy, so effortless. There was no sticking, no skipping, no sheerness. Very impressed, no complaints there. And then the shimmers, like I said, I had to go into this expecting to have very soft shimmers because that's what I'm finding in the Lake Como palette. So going into that, knowing that, I wasn't disappointed at all because the shimmers in here are definitely very soft. I wouldn't say that the shimmers are my favorite formula I've ever tried because I definitely like something a little more metallic and wet looking. And for these, I wouldn't really describe them as wet looking. I feel like you can kind of get it there because like the look today, I feel like looks very pretty and shimmery, but definitely it's still not wet looking, if you know what I mean, when we're talking about like very foiled metallic eyeshadows. It's not at that level. However, if you're someone who likes a nice shimmer, a very sparkly type of shimmer, you're gonna find that with this palette. I was very pleased overall with it. It kind of looks a little bit repetitive when you're looking at this palette online because I feel like when I saw it, I was like, there's two purple shimmers, there's two kind of peachy orangish shimmers, there's two kind of yellow goldish shimmers. But as you guys saw with the swatches, I feel like, well, yes, they're similar, they're very different, and especially these two, which I thought were the closest in the palette, there one's definitely more of a topper. And I'm very curious as I continue to test this and do more looks to see how much versatility I can get with this palette, because it's all, you know, it's basically a monochromatic palette, so it's all going to kind of look the same, but they did give you options here with those purples, with the oranges, with the yellows, and I really like how they broke it up that way, so I'm curious to see what I can do with it. The two shades that I feel like I'm not going to get a whole lot of use out of are definitely these, but they're there. I don't know, two out of this whole palette, I'm not mad at it, but just looking at it, they don't excite me, I'll say that much. So yeah, I don't have too much more to say besides that. I'll leave down below in a pinned comment and let you guys know my wear test, because like I said, I've only been wearing it a couple hours, so I don't really have that for you. And yeah, that's about all I have to say. You guys saw the tutorial, you guys saw the swatches. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. I'd love to hear what you guys think. Do you guys like the look I got? Have you guys tried Nomad's Cosmetics formula? I feel like it's definitely a very interesting formula. It's a very unique formula, I should say, when it comes to indie makeup. It's definitely very much like their formula. When I touch this, I'm like, oh yes, that's Nomad. And it's very different from what I have, the other brands that I have in my collection. And so that sets it apart, and I think that's really neat. And like I said, it's just a very effortless formula when it comes to their mattes. And if you're someone who likes to just take one, you know, shadow into your crease, maybe one on the outer corner, and pop on something on the lid and call it a day, and you don't want to take a lot of time blending, I feel like Nomad's formula is going to be one you should check out because it's just so easy. You don't need to take a lot of work if you don't want want to. But yeah, I think that's gonna do it for my thoughts. I'm just kind of rambling here at the end. Let me know if you want to see 3 looks 1 palette. In fact, go ahead and go over to my community tab and vote. I put a community tab or like a poll up a couple days ago asking if I can only do 1 3 looks 1 palette plus review video, which would you like to see? And the palettes I have up there is this palette, the Glamlight Ice Cream Dream palette, and then also the Worldly palette from P. Louise. Those are the 3 new palettes that I have. I'm not gonna be able to do 3 looks 1 palette with all of them, I don't think. So please go vote. At the time of me like recording this, the Glamlight is by far winning. So if you want to see 3 looks with this, go cast your vote to help this one out and see if it can get closer to winning or beat out Glamlight altogether. But definitely go over there and vote, because that'll help me decide which palette to focus on and which palette to do a 3 looks 1 palette with. But yeah, to end out this video, I just have to give Nomad a really big shout out in just their presentation and their packaging. Outstanding. And I am always so excited whenever a palette packaging that's gorgeous not only looks beautiful on the outside, but you can see the story here on the inside within the color story of the palette, and they totally did that, so I'm always very happy. It will never cease to frustrate me when a brand launches a palette with a gorgeous color story, gorgeous packaging, and then you open it and it's like all browns or something like that. So I really give them props for that, and then also just props for the way they launch their palettes. I know I've mentioned this before, but I absolutely love how they launch the palettes. It's so much fun how they get their audience and their customers involved in guessing and whatnot, and it was so much fun as I was sitting there Googling trying to figure out the clues. I always have a great time whenever they launch a new product, and I was just very excited to see that their new palette they launched was something I could get really excited for, because the last one, the orange, I think it was the Orient Express is what the palette was called, it just wasn't my speed. Like, there were colors that I really liked, but as a whole it wasn't kind of up my alley. But this one I could get down with. Even though I can't get a lot of depth with it, I can still get down with it at a very light monochromatic summery palette. But yeah, I'm gonna stop talking at this point. I hope you guys found my first impressions along with the swatches and tutorial helpful and informative, and if you did, please let me know that down below in the comments, or just hit the thumbs up button on your way out, as it helps me in the whole YouTube algorithm. And if you want to continue getting daily content from me, I'm over on Instagram, I'm LadyKatie92, and I upload there about every day, or I post there about every day. But yeah, with all that said, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you very soon in my next video. Bye guys.